Pemirsa, negara Hungaria di benua Eropa menjadi salah satu mitra strategis Indonesia. Hubungan bilateral kedua negara ini terus ditingkatkan. Menteri Luar Negeri dan Perdagangan Hungaria Peter Szijjártó memaparkan ketertarikan Hungaria terhadap kerjasama teknologi manajemen air, pendidikan hingga investasi Hungaria di ibu kota Indonesia baru. Berikut wawancara Sarah Wayne bersama Menteri Luar Negeri dan Perdagangan Hungaria.
Pemirsa, sebagai dua negara yang sudah memiliki hubungan bilateral sejak tahun 1955, Indonesia dan juga Hungaria memiliki sejumlah kerjasama di berbagai bidang, mulai dari ekonomi, politik, dan juga sosial budaya. Dan untuk itu, hari ini saya akan membahasnya bersama Menteri Luar Negeri dan Perdagangan Hungaria, Mr. Peter Szijjártó. Welcome, Mr. Peter Szijjártó, to Jakarta, Indonesia, first of all.
Thank you for the invitation. Happy to be here.
We're glad that you're here as well. First of all, Mr. Szijjártó, we would like to talk about Hungary's foreign policy, which Hungary has decided to take or pursue the path of pragmatic foreign policy. Can you please tell us more on how that will benefit the relations between our two countries?
Look, we are a small Central European country, and we have a very small but a very open economy. And in order to make this economy strong again, we had to put a lot of emphasis on the external factors like exports and the foreign direct investments to be enhanced. And in order to be successful on these areas nowadays, you have to be very pragmatic, and your foreign policy should serve the economic interest of your country. So we have merged two very important capacities within the government. One, the external economic relations, and second, the foreign affairs. So a ministry integrated called Ministry of External Economic Cooperation and Foreign Affairs have been created. Their sequencing is very clear, and all political activities must serve the national economic interest of the country.
But before we talk more on the economy, politically, what kind of relations does Hungary and Indonesia is interested in?
Look, we respect the role Indonesia plays in the multilateral world currently. We understand that there are similar kind of challenges you are faced with like Europe does. Mm-hmm. Of course, different dimension, different location, but similar kind of challenges, especially when it comes to threat of terror.
Yes.
We understand that ISIS does have activities here in this region as well. ISIS has an impact on the European security as well. So what really combines us or connects us is our participation and commitment towards the global fight against terror. Mm-hmm. Both you and us are members of the anti-ISIS global coalition. We understand that you are struggling with this phenomenon. Europe is struggling with this phenomenon as well. On the other hand, we respect your role played here in this region as a stabilizer. Mm-hmm. So when it was about your candidature to the Security Council of the United Nations, we were very strong, committed, and loud supporters
yes.
of that.
Thank you for that. You gave your support.
Yeah, of course
for
we did, and we were happy that mm-hmm. Indonesia made it.
Yes.
We are happy that you were successful, mm-hmm. and we are happy that you are still there, and you are an active participant in the work of the Security Council. On the other hand, we really enjoy this pragmatic cooperation, meaning that whenever we meet, mm-hmm. we never deal with the internal issues of each other.
Yes, I mean, just cooperation.
Yeah, we leave it to each other because mm-hmm. you know it's well above our payroll to deal with internal issues of other countries. We have our job mm-hmm. to deal with internal issues of our own country.
True, and we have to remember and note the mutual respect that we have with the two countries.
Absolutely.
And now talking about the economy, as one of EU's largest or fastest growing economies in 2019. How does Hungary view the potential economy here in Indonesia? Because you have also stated before that the economic relations have progressed, especially within the past few years.
Yeah, actually, you know, we respect a lot your economic policy, which is considered as successful rightly, given the fact that you perform a 5%+ growth rate, which is not easy nowadays. We do the same. We have the highest growth rate of the European Union. You have a very significant growth rate as well. This gives us a chance to cooperate. And we understand that a robust number and robust volume of infrastructural development projects have been happening and will be taking place in the future as well here in Indonesia. And this opens up the opportunity for Hungarian companies to invest here. We just concluded a $36.4 million Tide Aid credit program, in the framework of which 36 water sanitation facilities have been introduced and implemented by Hungarian companies. Now we are negotiating about the second phase of this Tide Aid credit program, which would be a volume of $150 million, would focus on healthcare in a form of delivering medical devices, especially on the field of oncology, to three of your public hospitals. But a Hungarian-Indonesian joint venture has been working on the feasibility study of the introduction of the electronic tolling system on your roads and highways. This study will be completed in January. According to your Minister of Public Works, the procurement phase would be launched in April, and within half a year afterwards, contract can be signed to start to implement the system, hopefully with Hungarian success.
And talking about economy and also the ETOL, we can't separate it from the growing or emerging landscape of the digital economy, also here in Indonesia. And Budapest is also one of the five cities in Europe with one of the biggest environment of tech and startups. And there has been discussions in the past as well on how we can cooperate as two countries. How do you see this potential in Indonesia?
Look, here we have some forward runners as well. Mm-hmm. The Hungarian economy is now under a kind of change of dimension. Mm-hmm. So with digital economy gaining more space and digital solutions are playing more and more important role, Industry 4.0 and Internet of Things comes forward.
Yes.
You definitely need an environment which is not only ready to adjust itself to these new technologies, but which makes the competitors or the stakeholders able to compete on this market. So not only to follow the changes, but to generate the changes through new technologies as well. When it comes to IT and when it comes to such kind of digital industry, Hungary has a relatively good position. Given the size of the country, we are always interested in competitions where qualitative measures mm-hmm. or aspects can be decisive rather than mm-hmm. quantitative, because we are small. So that's why these high value-add industries are significant for us. Your telecommunication company, Telkom Indonesia, has bought 30% share in a Hungarian IT company, which plays an important role in working on electric platforms mm-hmm. And e-wallet, and we hope that this is going to be the first very spectacular major step of cooperation. 30% of the shares of this Hungarian company are now owned by Telkom Indonesia, and hopefully we're both going to take advantage of this cooperation.
Talking more about the current issues here in Indonesia, Hungary has stated its interest in investing in our planning on moving our capital city to Kalimantan. Can you tell us more on why Hungary has said to show an interest in investing?
Look, we understand it.
And then can we also talk about the water management system here in Indonesia, where that you have also stated that you have invested in
yes.
the water management system. Can we also talk about the sharing of knowledge?
Yeah.
If there are any plans of sharing of knowledge between Hungary and also Indonesia regarding the water management process?
Sure. Hungary is considered as a country of rivers. Mm-hmm. So we've been working a lot on developing technologies which make it possible to take the most advantage of having such national or natural yes. resources, because these are basically only natural resources
yes.
what we have there in Hungary, including hot springs and wells. So based on that, we have developed a water management technology, mm-hmm. Water management science, the products and services of which are basically looked after in many parts of the world, including Indonesia, where we have delivered 36 water sanitation facilities. Now we understand that tens of millions of people still do not have direct access to potable water. This is something that has to be completed, and we are ready to cooperate on that. We have a scholarship program between the two countries, based on which 100 Indonesian students can study on Hungarian universities, fully financed and covered by the Hungarian state on an annual basis. And I came to an agreement with the respective ministers here that part of these 100 scholarships will be used by students who study some water-related science. And with this, the Hungarian technology and know-how will be shared with the Indonesian
students,
through which this knowledge can be spread over here in this industry.
Okay, and then talking more about the current issues here in Indonesia, Hungary has stated its interest in investing in our planning on moving our capital city to Kalimantan. Can you tell us more on why Hungary has said to show an interest in investing?
Look, we understand it's a big project.
Yes.
I mean, moving a whole public administration to a totally different part of the country, that's going to be demanding. We respect a lot the braveness of your leadership to enter into such a project. And I mean, we cross fingers for the success of that, of course. We have seen such kind of experiments already. I mean, if you look at Brazil, for example, that was the same pattern, and in some other countries where moving the capital gave a boost to a area which could be considered as remote until then. So we understand the rationale behind, and we understand that huge infrastructural developments.
Last but not least, Mr. Sijarto, talking about Hungary and Indonesia, we can't separate the bilateral relationship apart from people-to-people relations between our two countries. How can we promote Hungary in Indonesia and likewise Indonesia in Hungary? Because as you said, our two countries are separated by distance and then access as well. What is the best way?
Well, actually, you Indonesians have an easy job in this regard, because if you say just one word named Bali in Hungary, then you are definitely get a very positive approach.
Many people from abroad know Bali, only Bali.
Yeah,
but they don't know Indonesia as a whole.
No,
is it the same
course.
Condition in Hungary?
You know, it's very similar to Hungary, because the brand Budapest is even more well known than the brand Hungary. So sometimes we have the feeling that people don't even know that Budapest is the capital of Hungary, but they know it's a beautiful city. So we have the same challenge, let's put it this way. So those millions of tourists who visit Hungary on an annual basis, they basically visit Budapest. And although we make some efforts to extend their programs, actually so far we have had, limited success. But I mean, time's going on. Hopefully we're going to be more successful. In this regard, maybe a similar kind of challenge has been there. But tens of thousands of Hungarians visit Indonesia on an annual basis. Bali is a very popular
destination.
Vacation destination. Look, one thing would be really important to improve the connectivity between the two countries. Of course, it would be, I mean, too much and unrealistic to launch now a direct connection between Budapest and any destination here in Indonesia. But what really would make sense to find the rational flight path. Mm-hmm. So with one transfer in a, let's say, affordable time frame to raise Hungary and vice versa raise Indonesia would definitely be helpful. And country branding, of course. That's why I'm very happy that now we have increased the number of Indonesian scholars in Hungary to 100, because I mean, after 1 year they return, I hope they will be promoters and goodwill ambassadors of the bilateral relationship and of Hungary itself.
Because it's also based on their experience.
That's right. That's what we hope for. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mr. Peter Sijarto, for your time.
Thank you.